University of North Dakota, ILMA Habitat, doing a 2-week long study. For one of the research projects I'm going to be doing here is I'm trying to measure the amount of impact that a single analog astronaut myself has on the habitat. So I've tried everything I can to minimize my overall resource utilization from the habitat, be it the water from the habitat, the power, actual weight that I'm bringing in, and trying to just keep track of my overall impact. So what I have here is the food that I've brought. I want to talk about item by item what we have here and kind of why I've chosen to bring what I've brought. So first thing is just a typical water bottle. This water bottle is just super basic, but I chose it because it's really light. It's lightweight. It's not like like a hydro flask or any type of like really, really tough, like plastic heavy bottle. It's a light bottle, over the counter, but durable enough. I've actually used a water bottle like that for over a year before, just one of them. And then I got little ticks on it. All I'm doing is every time I finish up one of these water bottles, I put another tick on it, and that's what I use to keep track of how many ounces I'm using throughout the entirety of the mission. This water bottle is 20 ounces large, so I just add it all up at the end. I'll get my total water output, or intake, rather. We got a titanium pot here. Again, it's really light, durable, and I can use it to heat water. I've chosen to cold soak food, so I'm not going to be using it to heat water, but you could use it for that. It's also something unique about it. This particular titanium water bottle is it has a lid, so you could just throw a bunch of food in it. You use it as a container. You could, when you're done eating, you can actually like close the bottle down and just use it to keep leftovers. You can put water in it. You can use it as like an additional water bottle. So a lot of advantages to having a titanium pot, especially one that actually seals. Similar to the titanium pot, we've got this plastic cup. It's just an old like ice cream jar of ice cream, but again, it's extremely light. That's why I chose it. Also, you can put a lid on it. You can use it to hold water, mix food, keep leftovers. Again, having a lid, it's easy to clean because it's wide mouthed. I can actually get in there and clean it. So this is all my cooked materials. I just have one spoon, again, titanium, super light. One thing about the weight of items is seems like ounces don't necessarily count, but when you start adding them item by item by item and you go through every single item, it comes out to pounds at the end, several pounds. And when it comes to space travel, weight is a huge constraint. So smarter we can be about our weight, the better. All right, so this is food. This is one day of food. Again, as I talked about earlier, I went with a camping style food arrangement. So there's a lot of freeze-dried food in here. Tried to balance it out as much as possible, but this is something pretty typical of hiking food, okay? Total weight of this food, all told, is less than a kilogram. It's actually closer to half a kilogram. I believe I weighed in at 0.55. So, just gonna talk through the items here. So first item I have is just oatmeal. Super easy to make, really light, and it's got enough energy in it. It's also got some fiber. I just throw the oatmeal in the cup, throw some water, and let it soak for longer than you typically have oatmeal soak. I just kind of let them soak overnight. A good rule of thumb is when you're cold soaking and you're not using fuel, just start soaking the next meal at your current meal. So when I have dinner tonight, I'm gonna start soaking my oats for the next morning. I chose to do cold soaking because, again, I'm trying to minimize the impact on the habitat. And so anytime I'm having to use fuel or energy to heat water, it's just, it's power that doesn't necessarily have to be used for the food. So I'm just cold soaking. Cold soaking is not really that I don't find it to be that bad as long as you give the food enough time to soak. And once it really gets to room temperature, it's no different than just having some leftovers. So that's the first item. Next, you got your craisins. So some dried fruit, you could use anything. Dried cherries are really good, dried blueberries, some type of dried fruit. It just kind of livens up the oatmeal a little bit. Protein powder, nutrient dense, so it's a lot of protein for the weight, pretty much. You know, when you're trying to preserve weight, you want your food to be light, but not only that, you want to get the most nutrients out of the light food. So again, that's another reason why I have like just a builder bar in here. You could use any type of like energy bar or exercise bar, but these are good because again, they're nutrient dense. There's a lot of nutrients for the amount of weight that they are, but they're also balanced, which is also important when you're trying to preserve weight. So they've got, you know, the balance between the protein, the carbs, and the fats is really good on most exercise bars. I've got figs here. Figs carry a little bit more vitamins and minerals than maybe like protein powder would carry, so that's pretty good. But most importantly, they've got some fiber in them, more fiber than most foods would. And since we've got a lot of freeze-dried, high preservative foods with lots of salt, it's important to get some fiber in there as well. So I have some figs for that. Speaking of fiber, also got some fiber supplements here. Just because, again, you know, you're getting jammed up with all this sodium and highly preserved food. You need to make sure you're at a minimum getting the fiber that you need. So when I kind of worked all these calculations out, realized I needed a little bit more fiber. So that's what these little gummies are, little gummy fibers. Just a multivitamin, just to make sure covering all the bases. And then finally, we've just got, got some trail mix here. I have a couple different types of trail mix. Most of them have more nuts. This happens to be just a traditional mountain type trail mix, but most of the trail mixes I brought on this are like have like some fruits, some dried fruits and nuts in them. So and then finally we got dinner. So this is a Mountain House meal, or this is just a typical camping freeze-dried dinner. You don't have to get something like this. Simple instant mashed potatoes or any type of just add water type food is fine if it's got, you know, if that's your prefer, if it's got what you want in it. So like a lot of times I'll bring instant mashed potatoes or what is it, ramen, anything like that. And anything that you can just add water, you can definitely use those. I grabbed Mountain House just because I actually happen to have those on hand. So I just grabbed a couple and threw them in there. But that's how that works. All of this food combined, I already talked about the weight, all of it combined comes out to just over 2,000 calories. I think I'm sitting somewhere between 2,000 to 2,200 calories total per meal. Slight variations. So gonna see how that works out. I am tracking heart rate, caloric, how many calories I'm burning each day, and my overall weight throughout the entire simulation. So just gonna try to dial in exactly what the caloric intake needs to be. If it needs to be a little bit higher, I'll do that I'll tweak it. But this is what I'm working with on this study, and we'll see how it goes. Thanks.